Grégoire Mallard, welcome to the SNIS Geneva studio. Together with two other colleagues, Farzan, Sabet and Jin Sun, you have written an article on the global sanctions regime and its relation to humanitarian aspects. This article has won the International Geneva Award 2020. We'd like to ask you to tell us a little bit more about it and about its findings.
Well, thank you very much, and thank you to the jury for selecting this article for the prize, for one of the prizes. This article is an exploration of recent developments in the global sanctions regime, with a particular emphasis on the weight of US sanctions on humanitarian trade or trade of vital goods. So what we identify in this US sanctions regime, which has global reach, is that there is a humanitarian gap in the sense that countries who cannot apply to get a license in the United States for authorizing some trade in vital goods, then cannot export these vital commodities to sanctioned territories. So we identify this gap, its origins, its causes, and we try to present different solutions to fix that problem.
Talking about solutions, what exactly are some of the ways out or some of the fixes that you could explore in this article?
So in this article, we explore two types of solutions in relation to two types of problems. The first problem is the lack of a multilateral licensing authority. In general, the trade in vital goods operates under general license, whether you want to export medicine, food, or other types of vital products to a sanctioned territory, you should have a license, an authorization to do so. But there are recent evolutions in the global sanctions regime that actually require some trade exporters to require specific licenses. And here we present an argument in favor of the creation of a multilateral licensing body that could work under the aegis of the United States or other forums like the G20 or an extended club of states, of exporting states. There's also another problem, which is that even though these exporters in vital goods may have the license, they may not find the banks that would authorize the payments and transfer payments from sanctioned territories because of their different risk appetites. And there has been a lot of debates on the creation of a European special payment vehicle, for instance, in relation to Iran, which we explore in the paper, or the Swiss channel of payments that would allow a trade in vital goods to operate. But we propose a different type of solution, which is blockchain-based digital currency used for the trade of vital goods to operate payments and ensure traceability, security, and confidentiality. And we believe that this proposal can be discussed along the others by policymakers, and that's what we bring to the table.
Grégoire Mallard, thank you very much for your account, and we wish you all the best for the future.
Thank you very much.